Hello, my dear friend. So in the previous lecture, we studied the three-phase induction motor drive by changing the stator voltage. Now, the second method which we have to study is changing the frequency. Changing the supply frequency. So we have to change the supply frequency. So what will be the what will be the effect of changing the supply frequency? The synchronous speed of stator generated magnetic field will change. As we know that omega s, or this, let us say omega s. Omega s is directly proportional to supply frequency. So if we decrease this frequency, then our omega s point will change. The point at which the slip was zero will shift. So it is like just shifting the DC motor characteristic. By changing the D, we can draw new characteristic, torque slip characteristic. So if this is the at a particular F rated frequency, then if we just go on changing the frequency, decrease the frequency, so what will happen? This omega S will change. Now this omega S will be having a value somewhere here. If this is F1, and it will automatically change like this. This is decreasing frequency. Frequency is decreasing. So we can just shift this characteristic by changing this frequency. So whatever load we need to match, if this is the load, so it was rotating at this, so at this point. So if we want to rotate at this point, what we just need to do, we need to just select the appropriate frequency which shifts the torque speed characteristic of this three phase induction motor to here. So there are many electronic components that can vary the frequency, supply frequency, such as cyclo converter or back-to-back converter. But there is one problem in this method. The problem is that at reduced frequency, the flux of this the flux developed in the motor increases. So what that means, so we know that the EMF induced in the in this stator winding, that is ES, it will be nearly equal to VS supply voltage, and we are not changing supply voltage, mind you. So what this ES will be? This will be 4.44 F pi. Pi is the flux in the machine and number of turns. Number of turns in that phase winding into the speed. Rotating speed will come in the frequency part only. So this is the equation. So the EMF induced in the stator winding, that is also that is equivalent to back EMF which develops in the armature winding of a DC motor. So this is supply voltage, and ES is developed in the winding to oppose the current in the stator winding. So let us say ES is equal to VS. Okay, so VS is equal to 4.44 F pi, where pi is the flux in the machine. So if we calculate our pi, so our pi will come out to be VS upon 4.44 F TPH. So turns per phase we are not changing, VS we are not changing. We are changing this frequency. Frequency we are decreasing. So what will happen? if this denominator decreases, this flux will start increasing. So at a reduced frequency, there will be boost in flux in the machine. And we should always note that a machine is always designed at any point of its BH curve. What is BH curve? BH is, this is phi by A, and this is Ni. So this is always designed to be at optimized point, at its knee point. After, before this, this is nearly linear, means if we go on increasing this Ni, there will be a sufficient increase in this flux. But after this, there will be a saturation point. So the flux will not increase much. If we want to increase some flux, then we have to, if this goes to here, then a huge amount of Ni we have to invest. So Ni, new Ni will be too high. So this will, what this will create? This will create extra current, extra magnetizing current you will need to boost this flux in saturation region. So extra current will demand extra losses in the winding, and the machine will be developing higher heat as well. So just decreasing this flux will not address our problem. We cannot increase this flux. So the another method, which is the third method which we have to study, that is changing. This third method is changing voltage and frequency. So why voltage and frequency both? Because we are just trying to maintain this Vs by F to be constant. We will decrease this frequency, and same how we will decrease this Vs as well. So at reduced frequency, we will be having reduced voltage, which will be, this will be constant. And if this becomes constant, then this phi will also be constant. This is called V by F control method. This method is also called V by F control method. V by F control method. So these are the three methods which we have to study. Let us have a review of that. So first is by varying the supply voltage. So as you vary the supply voltage, so your torque will be reduced. So as you the torque reduces, but the initial point will not change. So just the slope will decrease, and you can just change this slope to match the new requirement, your new operating requirement. So this is how you can do by changing this voltage. And then next you can change this frequency. So as you go on decreasing this frequency, your characteristic will just parallelly shift. Okay, because this omega s, this initial point depends upon this frequency, what frequency you give to the stator winding. So as you decrease the supply frequency, this will shift, and you can match the new operating characteristic. But this has got problem, as frequency is reducing. This frequency will boost our flux, which will create more losses in the stator winding. So what we do, we simultaneously vary our Vs and Vs by F. So we reduce frequency, we reduce voltage, supply voltage as well. But this is what you do when we need to reduce the speed of your drive. But what will happen if you increase, if you want to increase this speed? So what will be that in that case? If you want to increase the speed of your rotor beyond beyond the rated speed, so there is only one option remaining, which is by increasing the frequency. So you can always increase the frequency. If you increase the frequency, this characteristic will shift parallel to towards our right. So we can always have a operating point which is higher than the operating point of the rated operating point. So mind you, at increased frequency, what you will have, you will have a reduced flux. So your main flux, the flux generated by the stator winding, will reduce. And when this flux reduces, you know the torque will also reduce. The electromagnetic torque generated by the motor will also reduce, because this electromagnetic torque generated by this rotor is directly proportional to your flux generated by the stator. And there will be a reduced torque, which you always have in flux weakening region. So you can draw the this characteristic, the torque versus speed characteristic, torque and power versus speed characteristic, that up to rated speed, let us say this is our rated speed, up to rated speed you are not playing with your flux, you are always maintaining your flux to be constant, so always your torque will be constant. Okay, so this is for torque, and let us draw our power to be in red ink. So our torque, if you are maintaining our flux constant, so your torque will always be constant. Okay, and if you go beyond this rated speed, what you have to do, you have to do increase in frequency, and which will decrease your main flux, and therefore you will be having torque which is dipping. So now after beyond the rated speed, beyond this rated speed, the torque will be inversely proportional to your speed. Okay, if you go want to go beyond the rated speed, so what you will have, you will have reduced torque. So this region is called constant torque region. Constant torque region of your drive. In this region, what will be the power? So power is T into omega, and T is constant, but omega is increasing. So P will linearly increase up to a rated speed. And beyond this, the torque will be, this is wrong. This is not directly proportional. This is inversely proportional. So I did a mistake, because as you go on increasing beyond the rated speed, the torque is dipping. So torque is inversely proportional to this rotor speed. So what will be your power? So power will be T into omega. So T is 1 by omega. So omega into 1 by omega into omega will be cancelled out, and you will get a constant power. So you will get constant power. So this region is called constant power region of your drive. So this is how we used to change the operating speed of your three-phase induction motor. In the next lecture, we will do some advanced drive strategy, which is vector control. So for that, I will devote some more lectures. And after vector control, you will be having direct torque control. So in the unit 6, only two topics are remaining. So thanks for now.